Hey, welcome and thanks for joining. Do you have an application that invokes a web API? And this API needs to invoke another downstream API? And not sure how to configure it? This video is for you. My name is Joel Horowitz, and I am product manager with the Microsoft Customer Experience Engineering team. And in this video, I will explain the on behalf of scenario and how it can help you design, develop, and secure your applications and APIs that invokes another API using Microsoft Authentication Library. I will also show you how to configure Microsoft Entra ID or Microsoft Entra External ID for consumer-facing applications. The on-behalf of flow authentication or OBO flow is used in scenarios where an application calls a web API, which in turn calls another web API. Consider the following scenario. A user signs into an application, and the application acquires an access token to call a web API you developed. Then the application invokes a web API, passing the access token in the HTTP request, and this works as expected. However, if the web API tries to call a downstream API, for example, Microsoft Graph, using the same access token, it will fail, because each API has its own set of permissions, and in most cases, also a unique identifier or audience. If you are not familiar with the audience, in OAuth 2 terminology, the audience claim refers to a unique identifier of the intended application or API that should accept the token. The on behalf of flow solved this problem by exchanging the access token with a new one that can be used to call a downstream API. Now let's see how it works. After a user authenticated an application, the application acquires an access token to call the first API. We will call this API the middle tier API. The access token with the corresponding permissions is passed in the HTTP request, also known as a bearer token. To be able to invoke the downstream API, the middle tier API calls Microsoft Entra ID token endpoint to exchange the access token it received with a new one that fits the downstream API permissions. Microsoft Entra ID issues a new access token on behalf of the user with the required permissions and audience. And this is why the flow is called on behalf of, because Microsoft Entra ID issues a new access token on behalf of the user. After acquiring a new access token, the middle tier API invokes the downstream API, passing the new access token. The downstream API validates access token permissions and audience, process a request, and return data back to the caller. Sounds complicated? No worries. Microsoft Authentication Library, or in short, MSA Library, and Microsoft Identity Web Library for web application do everything for you. All you need to understand is that your application can call a web API that can call another downstream web API. Now let me show you an example of on behalf of flow. For the demo, I will use Wood of Groceries Live Demo, which is a global retail food store that is integrated with Microsoft Entra External ID for their online food shopping application. Navigate to woodgrovedemo.com and choose the Select a Use Case button. From the list of use cases, select the on behalf of use case. Read the instructions and select the Start Use Case button. Wood of Groceries use Microsoft Entra External ID, so you can create a new account by yourself or sign in with one of the social accounts options like Facebook. I already have an account, so I enter my credentials. After I signed in, I will be redirected to the token page. You can also select your name from the header, which will take you to the token page. In the token page, I select Access Token to call a web API button. It shows two links to the JWT.ms application with the access tokens. The first access token is the one used to call the middle tier web API, the account API, and the second one shows the access token the middle tier web API acquires to call the downstream web API, the payment API, which in this case is a resource API. Let's compare the access tokens to understand the on behalf of flow. At first glance, it appears that it's the same access token, same name, same OID, which is the user object ID, and most of the other claims. However, the token for the middle tier audience claim start with B97B, while the token for the downstream API start with BAC4C. As a reminder, the audience claim value is always the client ID of the target API. The token for the middle tier scope is account.read, while the token for the downstream scope is payment.read and payment.read/write. And finally, the ACP claim represents the client ID that acquires and uses access token. In this example, the downstream API ACP claim now has a value of the audience of the middle tier API. It indicates that the middle tier API requested this access token and used it to call the downstream API. So your APIs can always validate that the access token is intended for itself using the audience claim, the permissions using the scope claim, and with the caller using the ACP claim. Next, I'm going to show you how to configure Microsoft Entra ID. But before we start, there are a couple of terms you should be familiar with. First is app registration. To enable your application to sign in with Microsoft Entra ID and acquire an access token, you need to register your application. You should also register the APIs. The app registrations establish a trust relationship between the application, APIs, and Microsoft Entra ID. Once the API is registered, you expose scopes or permissions to other applications and APIs. In this example, the middle-tier API exposes the account.read and account.read/write. The downstream API exposes payment.read and payment.read/write. Finally, you configure what permissions application can act on the user's behalf. From the left side of the screen, the application is granted with permissions to call the middle-tier API. The middle-tier API is granted with permissions to call the downstream API. To configure the Microsoft Entra ID tenant, go to Microsoft Entra Admin Center. From the menu, select App Registrations. I will start with the downstream application registration. So I select the new registration, enter a name, and select Register. Copy the application ID and add it to your downstream API configuration file. This demo is a .NET Web API project, so I add it to the settings.json file. As you can see, I've already configured the tenant name and ID. Go back to Microsoft Entra Admin Center. From the menu, select Expose an API and select Add a Scope. On the first time you add a scope to an application, you need to configure its application ID URI. Accept the proposed application ID URI, add a scope name, in this example payment.read, a display name, and a description. You can leave the default values and select Add Scope. Add more scopes as necessary, like payment.read/write. In the downstream API project, make sure only tokens with the permission payment.read or payment.read/write are allowed. Access tokens without this scope will be rejected. Next, I'm going to register the middle tier API. Back to the application registrations, select new registration, enter a name, and select register. Copy the application ID and add it to your middle tier API configuration file. To be able to run the on behalf of Flow, this application registration requires your API to identify itself with a credential. There are several options to do so, like application secret or certificate. For security reasons, I choose the certificate option. So I upload a self-signed certificate I generated earlier. Next, the middle tier needs to be granted with permissions to call the downstream API, the permissions that I exposed in the previous steps. So from the menu, select API permissions. Under Configure Permissions, select Add a Permission. Select the API's My Organization Use tab. Select the downstream Web API application registration Select the payment not read or any other permissions you configure and select add permissions. Grant admin consent for your tenant for all users in the directory. Then, select the payment read permission you added and copy its ID. And add it to the middle tier API configuration file. Now your middle tier API can call the downstream API with its corresponding scopes. Next, you are going to expose permissions to the web application. From the menu, select Expose an API, then select Add a Scope. Accept the default application ID URI and enter a scope name like account.read, a display name, and a description. You can add more scopes like account.readwrite. In the middle tier API project, make sure only tokens with a permission account.read or account.readwrite are allowed. Finally, register the application. For this demo, I register a web application, but it can be any type of application. Enter a name for your application. And since it's a web application, we also need to enter a redirect URL. And select register. Copy the application ID and add it to your web application configuration file. The web application will request a token for Microsoft Entra ID, so it should identify itself with a credential. Again, I choose a certificate option, so I upload a self-signed certificate I generated earlier. For the web application to be able to call to the middle tier API, it should be granted with permissions configured in the previous scopes. From the menu, select API permissions, select Add a Permission. Select the API my organization uses tab and select the middle tier web API application registration. Then select the account.read and account.readwrite and then select add permissions. Again, grant admin consent for your tenant for all users in the directory. Then enter the scope account.read to the application configuration. That's all. I've registered two APIs and one application. I started with a downstream API registration and exposed two scopes to the middle tier API. Then I registered the middle tier API and granted permissions to the exposed scopes over the downstream API, so the middle tier can call the downstream API with the corresponding scopes. Also, the middle tier app registration exposes its own scopes to the web application. The web application is also registered to allow users to sign in. And finally, granted permissions to call the middle tier API. And now it's time to take a look on the code. The web application calls the create authorization header for user async function to acquire an access token to call the middle tier with its scopes. And the middle tier API also calls the same function, but different scopes as required by the downstream API. And this is where the authentication library behind the hood asks Microsoft Entra ID to issue a new access token for the downstream API. Now that you know how to configure the on behalf of Flow, you can take it to the next level by scaling this model to all your resource APIs. If you have multiple downstream APIs, configure the middle tier API to exchange its access token with new ones that fit the downstream resource API it invokes. Or a change of APIs, where the first API invokes a second API, and the second API invokes a third API. The first API will exchange its access token for the second API, and the second API will exchange its access token for the third one. Hope you have a good grasp on the on behalf of Flow. Before we wrap up, I would like to offer you a couple of closing thoughts and considerations when using the on behalf of Flow. The contract and the access token, including the audience, scopes, and ACP claims, would be rejected if supplied to the wrong resource API. So make sure to validate these claims. There are some configurations that you may apply to your application registration, like including the user security groups, application roles in the access token, or map additional claims in the access token. You may also configure conditional access policies for your applications. In all these scenarios and others, make sure the settings are also applied to the API application registrations. The code that I presented in this video varies from a web application to other types of applications and may change over time. Also, there are several ways to acquire an access token and invoke a web API with a bearer token. So, please read the MC library and Microsoft Identity web library documentation. You can find the link in the description below. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy it and see you soon. Goodbye.